Okay, here we go. We're on to page number 4 in the Paper Dream Album B portrait size. And the pages you're going to need are one of page number 4, which I've already put it together. And if you want to see how to do that exactly, I will link that video below. But it's this page, page number 4. And then you will need one of page number 8, which is this one. And this is album C, the 3x4 size. That is the main base page for that, but we're going to use it as a page, a flip page and pocket. And then you will also need page 17's medium belly band. We're going to use that one right there. And we might use some more pieces in this as inserts. We'll see. And then you'll also need that leftover side pocket from when we made page number 1. We used one part of it. So this time, for this page, we're going to use the second part. So this will be the last page in this album, and then we'll move on to the covers and stuff. So let me move this stuff out of the way, and we'll start putting it together. Okay, so like I said, I've already put the main base page together, and I've done that with the black and the white one as well already. And this paper line is Prima's Tales of You and Me. I will put in the description box below the link to the printables and the link to the playlist on YouTube so you can watch other videos using this template. And so what we're going to do first, I think what we're going to do first is we're going to add the pocket. So this is the main base page. Trying to see here what I might lack. So what all you need to do is take that second half of, this was also a part of the main base originally, and I cut it in half. And that's in a previous video for this size album. So then we just want to tab all the corners, and it's already been scored because we did that before we cut it in half. So that part's done. So we do that, and then you want to go ahead and prep all of your folds. Like that. And before you attach it, you want to go ahead and ink up the edges, especially that raw edge there that's going to be the pocket part. You want to go ahead and ink that up for sure. And I'm using Archival Ink and Coffee from Ranger. It's my favorite. And a Tim Holtz blending tool. So then I'm going to get my score tape. You use whatever you want to use. You can use wet glue if you want. You can use a tape runner, although some of those things, like a tape runner, may pull apart at some point. And it may not. It just depends. And you guys were asking about my little doggie that fell down the steps a couple of videos ago. She's fine. She is, I think she's 16 years old. She's old. And especially in doggy world, you know. And I think she's got a little bit of arthritis in her little legs because she's a little toy poodle. And I think she's getting a little bit disoriented, like she's, you know, like dementia or something, or is that, what is that, where you kind of forget what's going on. So anyway, so I think she just either shook the wrong way or missed a step or something and went tumbling down, but she's okay. She likes to be up here with me when I'm up here, so I had to block her off from coming up the steps, so she can't sit here and craft with me anymore. But that's okay. I don't want her to fall and get hurt. And she hasn't really complained about it. It's not like she's down at the bottom of the steps barking at me or anything, so I think she'll be okay. All right, so I'm just going to add, even though it looks like it might be upside down, I'm going to just go ahead and add it here. I just used a glue stick just to give me a few minutes of working time. And I'm just going to line it up and pop it on there. I usually never, ever, ever score this correctly. You know, the two pages don't ever get scored exactly the same. I don't know what happens, but that is what it is. So you just want to brush it down really good. So there's a pocket. And then the next thing I want to do is I want to add this as a flip page right here. So I'm going to get my paper trimmer out. This is my Fiskars Heavy Duty Precision Paper Trimmer. It is my favorite. And I'm going to go ahead and trim this bottom pocket off. We're going to use it too, but I wanted to trim that off first. And then I'm going to go ahead and trim this flap off, just like that. Oops, I didn't cut it very good. And then I'm going to trim this flap off, just like that. I'm leaving this flap on. I don't know, is this directional? Oh, it is directional, looks like. Huh. No, I have it the right way. I have it the right way. Okay, so I'm going to leave that on. I'm going to cut this off. I'm going to separate the two pieces here. I'm going to have to go back and trim that up. I did not trim that well. Maybe not. Maybe I'll just leave it. And then I'm going to cut this thing entirely out. I'm going to flip. I'm going to trim that flap off. And then trim that up. Move these pieces. And while I got my paper trimmer out, I'm going to go ahead and trim this all the way out as well. Okay, so I've got them all trimmed and I cut the corners off of these. And now what you want to do is you just want to score them. So this one is scored right there. And then score right there. Right there. Right there. This is a Martha Stewart scoreboard. I feel like I'm repeating myself over and over and over, but believe it or not, I get asked these questions, so I just decided I'd just tell you every time. Fold those and fold this one. And then before I put any tape on there, I'm going to go ahead and ink all of my edges. And I will be right back. All right, I've got all the edges inked up front and back. Like this one, I'm probably going to use it as an insert, so I inked up both sides. I inked up both sides of this one because it's a flap, and I put some tape on it. And then the pocket, I put tape on it as well. So what I want to do is I want to attach this flap here, like that. So I'm just going to remove my tape, the backing of my tape, and use my glue stick, and place it in here, maybe center, maybe off center. Let's just see how it goes. There we go, looks good, just like that. So now I've got the side pocket and the flap that comes over. It looks cool, doesn't it? So then I'm going to add this pocket to the front of that. Yeah. And some glue stick. And I'm going to open it up flat. Oh, I guess I could have put that on the outside. Oh, well, I wasn't thinking. That would have been pretty. Contrast, you know? Well, there we go. We're just going to add this. Line it up. I wish I'd have done that now. Oh, well. Didn't really plan that out very well. That's okay. So now we have this pocket, flap, pocket. All right, and flip it over. I'm going to use this medium belly band right here. And I am just, is that the one? Yeah. And I am just going to trim it out with my scissors. You don't always have to drag your paper trimmer out. You don't. And I'm going to score this one. You could cut these off if you want a tighter band. It's up to you. Depends on, I guess, what you're going to put in it. And then I'm going to fold these tabs back, brush them down a little, and I'm going to ink up the edges. Maybe I can put some like pretty flowers or something here to kind of offset that tone on tone look there. Okay. Oh, I need to put some tape. Just like that. And I'm going to remove the backing of the tape. Add my glue stick. Okay, and I'm going to put this up a little higher than normal. I'm not going to put it in the middle. There we go. I think I got that pretty straight. Just like that. So, the inserts, remember the inserts I'm doing, the black cardstock, and then I'm doing the old book pages. So I think I've decided I'm going to use the old book page on one side and the journaling lines on the other. So I've already pre-cut the insert there, and I've already pre-cut my old book page and my journaling lines. So I think I'm going to put this on this side and this on that side, like that, and that way there's room for you to journal on. And I think, no, better not use my tape runner. It rips that, it rips this delicate old book page paper sometimes. And then I'm just going to add this on here. Flip it over. These are already inked, of course. I might have already said that. I don't know. I can't remember. Just like that. And then this will go in here. Like that. And I think when we go to embellish and stuff, I think I'm going to put one of the wood embellishments down here to keep it from falling through. But I think that looks good. I like it. I like it a lot. Okay. And then over here is the standard insert. Same thing. And all this is, the black cardstock is really just the secondary mat for the main base B. And then the old book page is the traceable template mat. So that's all it is. And so I'm going to stick that there. And so I don't have an insert for here yet. I'm thinking what I'll do is the same thing. I will trace the insert. Let me get it. I didn't prepare that already. So that is, what page should I say that was? That is page 8. So I'm going to take this secondary mat and traceable template mat, and I'm going to find a scrap of black cardstock, and then I'm going to lay this down just like this, and I'm going to trace it out. And I'm also going to do the same with the old book page. I wonder if I can get two of them out of here. Probably not. Oops. Let me get the right size. No. Nope, I'm going to have to get another one. So I'm going to lay this down. And I've got it upside down so that I don't rip the paper with that tape. Just like that. Then you just want to cut it out. You want to cut it out right on the inside of that pencil line so that it's the right size. I'm gonna cut this out right inside the pencil line. So then this will go on top of here like that. And then it'll go in here like that. So I'm gonna ink this book page. Well, I guess I'll show you how I do it, why not? I just get me a scrap paper, that's all this is. And my ink. And I just literally just go on like this. Just start off of the page, or off of the book page, and just kind of hold it at a slight angle, and just kind of do a little circular motion. It's just that simple. Bam, done. Okay, so then I'm gonna add it to this real quick with my glue. I like it that all the inserts are these old book page black cardstock combination. It looks really cool with this paper line, I think, anyway. And then stick it right in there. It's just like that. So, right, that was easy, right? So I've already done the black one and the white one. Oh, there's the, let me get both of those out. I didn't want to lose them. They don't have their inserts in them yet. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut out the black cardstock, the secondary mats for this one, and I'm going to cut out the traceable template mats to match this one, and I'll be back. All right, I have went through and I've tried to match up the paper from me printing it off onto the patterned paper, and I've cut out the secondary mats for the white one and the traceable template mats for the top for both of these. Okay, so I'm just going to start adding, I've already inked everything too, by the way. Everything's cut to size and I've inked everything. So I'm just going to start adding all the mats, which is easy to do once you get it all cut out. It just goes so fast. You guys are always making nice comments about my nails. Thank you very much. I do appreciate it. I was a nail tech for many, 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 many years. 18 years or something, and I was able to retire from that, thank goodness, because it was killing my back. But anyway, I still do my own nails, and I did my nails the other day, and I know some of you are going to be able to relate to this. Have you ever went and got your nails done and the nail tech said, oh, sorry, I have to use a brand new file on you? Which means it's super sharp, you know, and the files that I use were really, really good. They were Tammy Taylor. They were really good, sharp, awesome, awesome, disinfectable files. Well, anyways, so I had to get a new file out for myself yesterday, and I have just ripped my cuticles to shreds. It's hard enough to do your own nails in the first place, but then when you throw a sharp new file on top of that, oh goodness. Well, anyway, so they're kind of sore today, and I just thought I'd share that with you because I know some of you know exactly what I'm talking about. Okay, so now I am not going to put a secondary mat on this part because the insert covers the whole entire thing, so I'm just going to leave that. And then I'm not going to mat this part again because of the insert and this part, okay? So I think, you know, if you look at it like that, you're saving paper, and it doesn't get as bulky, and it still looks wonderful. So, all right, so I've got all those matted. Now I'm just going to start going and adding these are the 3x4 journaling cards. Really cute, right? And I tried to get, I think that might be upside down. Like the inside of this, there was a little bit of flowers on top, so I tried to get one that had a little bit of flower in the purple. So I used these cards, and I've already inked them up. I didn't have to trim them or anything. But this goes on the inside of this flap here, like that. All right, and let's put this one on. Obviously, I mean, you could, I guess, make all three of these types of journals at one time, but obviously, you know, you don't have to do that. And can you imagine how fast it would go if you were just making one, you know? And then these also were 3x4 journaling cards, and I just cut a little piece off. I used my traceable template, and it's going to go right there. And it, believe it or not, it is the same paper. You just can't see. I think it's the same paper. I'm almost 100% positive. Well, that's what we're using because it's already cut down to size. I just used my traceable template and traced it and cut it with my scissors. Just that simple. And it just looks, it just comes together so nice. I'm going to add this one. Onto there like that. So nice. Okay, so these two pieces. Oh, look, my glue is like going, ah. These two pieces go right here and right here, and they were actually left over from doing the first page where we cut the 4x6 journaling card in half. Let me grab one. Right here. So where we cut that journaling card in half, I saved that other half, so this is the other half for both of these. And they're inked up as well. Let me try to get all that glue. Good grief. I'm rushing my glue and it's saying, no. I don't think so, young lady. All right, let me try not to make a mess here. Oh, this does have a direction. I'm not gonna press it down because I got a big old glob of glue. A big old glob of glue. Okay. And then put this one over here. And then the very last thing is to flip it over. And again, not matting these two parts. And these were leftover cut-off pieces from when you cut your 12 by 12 down to 8.5 by 11. You know, out of my scrap pouch there. So these were in there. The direction is wrong, but I don't think it really matters. I might end up putting, you know, flowers on there or a label on there or something. So then it goes like that, right? And then the inserts go in here just like that. So how, look how nice it looks. Just like that, right? So they look how awesome they are. Oh, let's put them in the right order. This one is, what do we got here? This one is the pattern paper. No, this one's not. This one's the pattern paper. This one is just using one template, and this one's using both. Good grief. Okay. I think I am going to go ahead and grab those wood embellishments. I'll be right back. Okay. So these are wood embellishments that go with the paper line, the Tales of You and Me. And since I need three of the same, those are just too big. There's only two there. Looks like there might be two butterflies. But I do have these here. I'll just use these teacups, I think. I thought I had three of something else, but I don't. So I'm just going to use those three cute little teacups right there. And I'm just going to attach it down here at the bottom in the middle like that so that this has something to go into. Does that make sense? Yeah, something to hold it. So my thinking is I'm going to put a tiny, tiny strip of this 3M foam adhesive stuff. I think I'm going to put a tiny strip on there. Let's just see how it goes. I guess I can always rip it up and do it again. Look at how tiny. Teeny, tiny, teeny. Okay, I'm going to put it on the back of this. Right down here at the bottom. Hopefully you won't be able to see it that well. And let's do it on the white cardstock one here first. Because I think I can easily get it up off of there. So I'm just going to find my center and I'm going to go all the way to the bottom of the page and press it down. Okay, so now it should slide just nicely, and it does. Fantastic. Yes, check that out. Adorable, right? I like it. Okay, so that's what I'm going to do, and it catches it really nice. Okay, I'm going to put all three of them on, and I'll be right back. Okay, so now I've got all the little teapots glued to the bottom of the pages. Aren't they cute? I wonder if I can show you the dimension. It's just a little bit there. See it? See the gap? Oop, I just covered it. And then there's the pattern paper one. Isn't that cute? It's a nice little stopper, right? So I was looking, and this, we've got this piece left over, which is the other part of the main base C. We've got this, and we've got these pieces left over from page 17. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to save these until we go embellishing the covers and the inside, the pages and whatnot, and maybe then we'll see where we might need an insert or something extra, a little something, something. So I think for now that these pages are finished. There is one, since this is the last page, I think what I'll do is I'll go ahead and get the side inserts ready and show you what that looks like. Okay, I've got all of these side inserts made, which is a lot. There's 16 of them because, remember, we're making three different books that have four pages each. So there's the other three pages, and then here's the fourth page. So that's how many pages we got going on. So I went ahead and made the inserts for all of them. So the reason I'm pointing that out is because the insert, let's see, page 4 it says the insert for the B album portrait is on page 13. So when you flip to page 13, which is this one, there's a lot of inserts on this page. So instead of printing this out 16 times, what I did was I made me a traceable template from the insert itself, okay? So then I laid it down onto cardstock, traced it out, and then I cut several of them at the same time. I did the, so I used, this is the black cardstock, okay? Whoops, I got two there. So the main base is the black cardstock, so I did that, and then the secondary mat is the old book page. So I did the same thing. I traced it onto one and cut out many at the same time. And with the old book page, I think I was able to cut out like 16 at a time, which is awesome because of my paper trimmer. So I ended up matting both front and back of these inserts. So I just wanted to point that out to you guys that you can make, instead of printing that out so many times, you can just make yourself a traceable template, and then you have it in your book whenever you need it. So I'm going to put that back. And so basically, I just wanted to show you what it's going to look like, the whole page when it's done. It's going to look just like that. Just like that. You see it? There we go. There's that one. And then, then there's that one. Of course, when you've got it already into the on the spine and everything, it'll have something to stop against. So they should all be the same or darn near. There, just like that. And all these other ones will go on the other pages. So let's lay these out. So we've got our pattern paper one. The only bad part about, like, again, I'm using the soft black cardstock, and when you cut multiples at one time, you kind of get the edges, you know? They're kind of like, I don't know, furry looking. But it does not bother me, but I just wanted to point that out. If you're going to cut multiple things at the same time, that tends to happen with soft cardstock. So. Okay, so we've got the pattern paper one, we've got the main base with just the traceable template on top, and then we've got all three mats. So they're looking pretty good. I like. So let me know which one you think you like the most. What's your favorite? It's funny, everybody's had a different opinion on this, and I think it's awesome because literally you've got three different styles of books here and they're using the exact same paper. So give me a thumbs up if you like this video. And the next video for this is going to be doing the covers. And I guess I'll see you next time. Bye.